RadioPlanner 3 allows you to plan and optimize low-power wide area networks such as LoRa, SigFox, NBFI, etc. The most common standard today is LoRa, developed by the LoRa Alliance. This video will demonstrate the main features of planning a small LoRa network in RadioPlanner 3. Main system parameters are entered in the network menu. The system type must be set to generic TRX. Here the downlink and uplink frequencies are set for which path loss calculations between the base and mobile station will be performed, and the threshold signal levels up to which the calculation will be performed are also set. The maximum calculation radius from base station is set here. The System Parameters tab allows you to set a number of other important network parameters. Firstly, all frequencies that will be used in the network are set, as well as the channel width. Secondly, the adaptive modulation table is populated. Each row of the table sets the modulation type as well as the corresponding signal-to-noise and interference ratio and the throughput value. For a LoRa system, you can specify the spreading factor and code rate as the modulation type. Finally, the noise characteristics of receivers are set. It is equivalent noise bandwidth, noise figure, and adjacent channel rejection. RadioPlanner 3 allows you to predict coverage for two typical mobile units. In the LoRa network, these could be sensors located at different heights or having different antennas, as in this case. Base station sites can be created in RadioPlanner in different ways, by importing points with coordinates from a CSV file, by entering coordinates manually or directly by right-clicking on the desired location on the map. After creating the site, one sector is automatically created. In the sector parameters, the user sets the necessary parameters of the transceiver, cable, and antenna. Most often, different sites have many of the same parameters. In this case, it is convenient to use the Global Active Sector Parameters Change feature. It is enough to enter the parameters for one sector and then apply the selected parameters to all active sectors. This project uses the default digital terrain model and the default clutter model, which is suitable for most cases. You can also use custom digital terrain model and clutter data in GeoTIFF format. For more information about how to use custom geodata, please refer to the user manual. The propagation model used here is ITU 1812, but you can also choose another model. In particular, the Longley-Rice propagation model is quite suitable for such a network. In the model parameters, you can specify time and location variability. If you do not want to take into account time and location variability, then set these values to 50%. Losses for different types of clutter can be entered manually, or they can be determined using the formulas of the ITU 1812 recommendation based on the average height of different types of clutter. The height for different types of clutter is specified in the geodata menu. For LoRa networks, the following uplink and downlink coverage prediction types are usually made. Received power, best server, signal to noise, plus interference ratio, maximum throughput, number of servers. In the Point Analysis menu, you can see the path profile and detailed results of the received signal power calculation at any point, as well as interference levels on co-channel and adjacent channels. Click on Point Analysis, then find the required sector in the interface tree and click on it. A path profile from the sector to the current point on the map will appear. You can change the current point on the map by clicking on the desired location. The path profile shows the height of the antenna radiation center of the selected base station and LoRa sensor, as well as the Fresnel zone for the radio beam, also loss in free space, diffraction loss due to terrain, and loss on clutter surrounding the LoRa sensor. In the Compare Coverage menu, you can compare the results of current coverage predictions with previously performed predictions. This allows you to evaluate the impact on coverage by changing various site parameters, propagation model, etc. To add a performed calculation to the comparison, click on Add Coverage to Compare on the top toolbar. When you go to the Compare Coverage menu of the main toolbar, this calculation result will be located on the left side of the screen, while the result of the current coverage calculation will be displayed on the right side. If the legend is enabled, it will display calculation parameters that the mouse pointer is currently over. You can add multiple calculations to comparisons, and their names will appear in the tree view interface under Compare Coverage. Coverage prediction results can be saved as an interactive web page in HTML format that can be saved to your computer's disk or placed on a server. This web page allows you to select a base map, change scale, view basic data from the legend, and display scale and current cursor coordinates. You can save the coverage result in an image file in PNG format. Before saving an image, you can select the area of the saved coverage using the frame. You can move both borders of the frame and the map itself. When saving images, you also select a resolution. The resolution may correspond with the current size or be 2 or 4 times larger. The higher the resolution, the larger the size of the saved file. You can save the coverage result in the structured KMZ Google Earth file. If the legend is active, it will appear in the upper left corner of Google Earth. Also, the result can be saved in geo-referenced GeoTIFF format, as well as in a text CSV file or exchange file map info for further coverage analysis in various GIS applications. In the Reports menu, you can create different types of project reports: Network Configuration Report, Propagation Model Report, Area Study Type, and Active Sites Configuration Report. All types of reports open directly in Excel. In the Fixed Wireless Access menu, RadioPlanner 3 allows you to calculate the detailed link characteristics from the base station to each LoRa sensor with its individual parameters. The parameters are as follows: antenna pattern, height and gain, transmitter power, cable loss, and penetration loss. In this menu, users can import sensors from a CSV file or manually create a new one on the map. Use different types of sensors. Adjust the antenna height for an individual or multiple sensors in the table. Manually or automatically assign sensors to base station sectors based on various criteria. View path profiles from the selected sensor to nearby base stations. Generate a report with the results of calculations in Excel. RadioPlanner 3 enables the display of coverage predictions for individual sensors on a map. The algorithm used to calculate coverage sensors differs from the one used for mobile units. This difference stems from the fact that while calculating mobile network coverage, the characteristics of one of two typical mobile units are considered. However, when calculating fixed wireless access coverage, the individual characteristics of the sensor are taken into account. These include antenna pattern, height and gain, transmitter power, cable loss, and penetration losses. As a result, coverage prediction is more accurate. Upon calculation, a small circle will appear at the location of each LoRa sensor. The color of this circle will correspond to the result of the selected study type. The study type can be chosen here, and the calculation can be initiated there using a special tool, Calculate FWA Coverage